Welcome to all my dear student to this online lecture. Today is your computer subject and I am your computer teacher. My name is Shweta Yadav. So before starting our lecture, I hope you all are fine at your home. If you don't wear your mask regularly, so please, whenever you go outside from your home, please wear the mask. Wash your hand continuously with the alcohol-based hand rub and avoid the close contact who has a flu-like symptoms. Okay? And now, see, in the previous lecture, we can done a paint, right? We can do a paint with the different shapes, right, students? So, now, I decide, in this lecture, we can do some exercise activity. Let's some filling the blanks, the one word question, name the following, true or false, like this exercise. In the every computer lecture we do some program, but practically, but now in this lecture we can do some changes, that is the question related to our subject and our program which we learn already, right? So, if you know the answer, please tell me. Otherwise, you know the answer and you learn something new from this lecture, right? So, in the before starting, I will explain you that in the previous lecture, we do a paint with the different shapes. We can fill the color and some of the students are doing it at home and they done very well and very nice. So if other one is listening this, so please you also try at your home. If you are having a computer, do practice on your computer, right? Now see, in this lecture, the first I will put thought one here. Mistakes are the strides we claim to reach success, right? It means in our life we have so many mistakes done, right? We can done so many mistakes, but we have to learn something new from this our mistake to reach our success. What? To reach our success. So let's start over the lecture. See, the first here, the question is filling the blanks, right? What is the question? Filling the blanks. So at the top, I will give here options. Monitor, double, number lock, desktop, operating system. These are the five option of this five FV. Now you have to read this FV and what you have to do? Match the answer. Which one is the correct to fill this blank? So read with me. I read the first FV. First is to type numbers using the numeric keypad on the right side of the keyboard. Dash key should on. What it means to type numbers? We have a keyboard, right? To type numbers, we have a keyboard, and in the keyboard we have a two side number key. One is the right side of the keyboard, as we see in the keyboard, and one is the top of the keyboard, right? Mostly we use the top of the keyboard, so we don't need any key to on our number key. But whenever we use this right side of the keypad, which right side of the keypad? So for use the number key of the right side of the keypad, we have to choose the key should on. It is a number lock. What is the answer? Number lock. So we put here answer number lock key, and you whenever you see the keyboard in the right side, you also have a number lock key. You can press the number lock key. It means the number of the right side, you can use it and you can write any numbers. Okay. Now, see the second blank. The first screen which appears when Windows is loaded is called dash. What it means? The first screen whenever we on the computer, the monitor will be display the screen, the first screen of this monitor. Which screen we can call them? Which screen? Choose from the given option. Which one is the correct answer from these five options? The first screen of the monitor that we see when window is on, it is desktop. What? A desktop. So second answer is the first screen which appears when window is on or loaded is called desktop. Right? It's called desktop. Now see here third one. The dash, clicking on the icons, open all the windows. Open all the windows. So clicking on the icons, open the windows. So which clicking? Which clicking? Double clicking. Which clicking? Double clicking. So the double clicking on the icon, you know that when we go in the computer lab, the second standard, third standard and the fourth standard know very well, we have to double click on the program so it will be open. The icon means a program picture, the first that we can see on the desktop, right? Whenever we search from the search tab, we can also see the icons. In every lecture I will call the icons, and you know that what is the icon? It means the program icon or program picture. Now come to the fourth one. The dash manage overall working of a computer. The dash manage overall working of the computer. So which one is the correct answer? That manage the overall working of the computer. Which one? The answer is operating system. What? Operating system. So the correct answer is the dash operating system manage overall working of the computer. Right? If you are not knowing the answer, so please read the blanks and remember the answer that I will speak in this lecture. Now see the fifth number blanks. The dash displayed processed information. What meaning of the displayed processed information? It means whatever we are doing in this computer, it will be shown which display? Monitor display, right? So the answer is a monitor, because you know that the monitor is look like a TV screen, and whatever we are doing we can see only on the monitor screen, right? We can see only on this monitor screen. So the answer is monitor displayed processed information. Processed information which mode? Nothing, but for example we have to open the notepad program. So what process we can done to open the notepad program? We can see on this monitor screen, right? Okay, now see, in this lecture we done this 5FB. So whenever we come to the Wednesday in computer activity lesson, I will ask the question and you have to must remember the answer, because in the Tuesday lecture we can done this, or you can Wednesday see the lecture. But if you are not knowing or not watch this lecture, so you have give me answer, otherwise I will give you, and you have to note down the answer so you can know the answers also. Now see the second question right here. The second question, which is what? Read with me. Write down the name of the following. Write down द नेम ऑफ द फॉलोइंग. सो हियर इज द ऑप्शन एंड वी हैव टू गिव दिस आंसर. वी हैव टू रीड द सेंटेंस एंड यू वी हैव टू थिंक विच वन इज द नेम ऑफ द फॉलोइंग सेंटेंस. राइट? ओके, नाउ सी द फर्स्ट वन. रीड. टू. It is a character from the right side of the cursor, the dash. Which one is the name of these two? It is a character from the right side. Which key? End key, shift key, delete key, page down, enter, and the caps lock. Which one is the correct answer to erase character from the right side of the cursor? Delete key. Which one? Delete key. Now see, from the erase character left side we use a backspace key. But if we want to erase character from the right side of the cursor, so we use a delete key. It means in the keyboard we have a two delete key, two erasing character. From the left side it is a backspace, from the right side we have a delete key. A backspace and delete key both are used for erasing a character, but we have a two different direction, left side and the right side of the cursor. Must No, the cursor, the blinking line that you can see on the program screen, it is called a cursor. Now, see the second question. Two, move the cursor to the next line. In every lecture, I will say this sentence. So, which key is used to go to the next line? Enter key. Which key? The enter key. Right? Now see the third one. Two. Place the cursor end of the line. It means what? For example, we are here, but now we want to come here at the end of the line. So which key is used for that? Only one press on the key and the cursor come to this side, to the end of the line. So which key? As the name suggests, which key here? End key. So the answer is the end key. In the keyboard we have an end key. You have to find where is the end key from the keyboard, right? See the four arrow key you can see in the keyboard, the cursor up, down, left, right. This side you can see the end key. So you have to must see where is the end key and you have to use it and you can see the difference. Now here the fourth one. To write in the capital letter, which key is used? You know very well, to write in a capital letter, which key? Shift key, page down, or caps lock? Which three options from these choose? Shift key is also right for capital letter and the caps lock key is also right for capital letter, right? But here I will choose a caps lock key to write in a capital letter, because only caps lock key is used to write in a capital letter. Shift key is also used for write in a capital letter, but there is a difference, right? We have to use the shift key and the which we want to write in a capital letter. We use this both key at a time. We have to press this key at a time. So the better used to write in a capital letter, every letter in a capital letter, so I will choose a caps lock key. Which key? The caps lock key. Now see the fifth one. To write a special symbols. To write a special symbols. For that we use shift key. Right? I will say in the lecture from the starting. For example, we have the @ sign, hashtag sign, $, percentage sign, ampersand, star sign, curly braces, semicolon, single quote, double quote, right? Square bracket, curly bracket. These all are the special symbols. So if you want to choose the special symbol, so we use a shift key. Which key? Shift key. We have to press the shift key with the one finger and the another finger in the special symbol. We choose and press both at a time, so the special symbol, it will be right in the screen. Now see the sixth number question. To move the cursor or page down by the key. What it means? For example, we are here. Now we have to come at the page downside, at the last. So which key? The page down key. Which key? Page down key is the name suggest. See, in the computer subject, the answers is mostly with the related to question. We just have to find the special name which is related to the question. For example, in this question we have a page down, so answer is also page down, so it is a special word. That is our answer, right? That is our answer. So these are the, write down the name of the following exercise, right? Remember this all the answer in the worksheet, in the Google Meet sessions, in the activity sessions. I will ask the question whenever I come in a activity session. So now see the next one, true or false. What? True or false activity. So we have to read these five question and we have to decide what is a true sentence and which one is the false sentence, right? So for a true sentence we write here true, or for the false sentence we choose a false to return. Now see the first, read with me. WordPad is the system software. Think, what is the system software? System software, it means the system that we install in the computer to work the computer. But the WordPad is the one, a program, right? Not a system. The WordPad is a one software program, but not a system software. So this sentence is false. So we return here false, right? Now see the second one. There are two enter key on the keyboard. There are two enter key on the keyboard. So you can see the two enter key in the keyboard. In the previous activity I will show it. So the sentence is true. So we can write here true, right? See the third one now. F2, this is F12. So F12 is the function key. Which key? Function key, the short name that we can see in the keyboard, right? So the F12 is the cursor control key. So see the first, understand that F12 is the function key. We have a 1 to 12 F12 key functions key, and it will, the question is that the F12 key is the cursor control key. We can control our mouse cursor that we can move on the screen like this. So it was a false statement. So false, right? Now see the fourth one. Windows XP is the latest version of Windows. So it was a false, because Windows XP is not a latest version, right? Now see fifth number. Show the desktop button is present on the extreme left of the taskbar. So desktop button, not it desktop button, but it was a start button that we can see on the left of the taskbar. So it also false, right? So this is our true or false question, right? So you also remember this question. Now the next one, match the following. What is the question? Match the following. So read with me. The first is system software. What? A system software. So from the choose the option, which one is the system software? Keyboard, pen drive, Windows 7, calculator, or printer? Which one is the system software? The answer is a Windows 7, because is operating system, we call them system software, and the Windows 7, it is the correct answer. So we can match here that the system software, it is a Windows 7. Now application. So keyboard is application, pen drive is application, calculator is application, or a printer is application. Which one is the application? Application means what? A program. So which one is the program? The calculator is a program, right? So we can match the calculator with the application, because the calculator is a one application program. In the computer, we can install it and we can use it for perform the addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, right? Square root, percentage. These all the functions of mathematics we can run in this calculator application program. Now, see the third one, input device. Input device. What it means? Input device, it means that device we can use it for input in the computer. Input means what? For example, we have to write numbers, we have to write letters, so we can use our keyboard. So the answer is the keyboard. So we can match the keyboard with the input device, because the input device, it is a keyboard, and from the keyboard we can give our input to the computer, right? Now output device, it is the opposite of the input. For example, we are written 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 numbers from the keyboard. Now which device is will be output device? So we can see this input. So it is printer. What? A printer. So the printer is output device. Why? Because the paper print which we are written in the monitor or in the computer. Now see the storage device. Storage device, which mean what? We can store our data in this. So the pen drive is the storage device. You know very well the pen drive. We can store our picture, image, movie, song, our school data, our books detail, right? Our contacts numbers also. We can store everything in the pen drive. That is a data. That is a soft data, right? Now see the next slide. The last question, answer in one word. Answer in one word. So read first question with me. Which is key is used to give a space between word? So which key is used to give a space between word? The longest key in the keyboard, that is a space bar key. A space bar key. So the longest key from the keyboard, it is a space bar key, and only space bar key is used to give a space between words. Now see the second question. How many functions keys are there on the keyboard? So the question is, how many functions key on the keyboard? Only that student will know the answer who can see the keyboard and calculate the keys, that how many keys, and they know the functions key. So the answer is 12 functions key, F1 to F12. You can see the F1, F2, F3, F4, F5, F6, F7, F8, F9, F10, F11 and F12. So total 12 functions key we have on the keyboard. And this functions key 12, we have a 12 different use. Right? Now the last one. Which program manage all the job of program? So the answer is operating system, because only operating system installed in a computer, then all the program, all the functions, all the jobs of the computer, it can manage. Only the operating system. For example, we have a Windows XP, Ubuntu, Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 9, Windows 10, Nava 12, 13, right? The latest version, 2017-18. So these are the operating system which can install in the program our computer, and the computer works very easily, faster, smoothly, right? And they can manage our all the task. So this is our exercise that we can done in this lecture. Which exercise we can done? Repeat again. FP, right? TF, name the following, match the following, and the last one, answer in one word. Right, this exercise we can done today. So our lecture is over here. In this lecture we can do exercise, so you have to remember must this answer. In the activity session I will ask the random question and you have to know very well. Right, so bye everyone, take care, please wear your mask, wash your hand continuously, and avoid the close contact who has a flu-like symptoms, right? We miss you all. All teachers are missing all students. And we know you also miss our schools, our teachers, right? So please take care. Watch the lectures. Come in the Google Meet sessions, right? Whenever we meet in the week twice. So please come, join the activity and enjoy the lectures and activities. Okay, so bye everyone. Take care, stay home, stay safe.